Welcome back to another episode for the devotional to the Kingdom Mindset book, which you can find on lulu.com. Just search the Kingdom Mindset, Joshua Joseph, and it should pop right up. Actually, also, we just released a ebook as well, and you can find it right under the same hard copy book if you wanted a hard copy. So anyway, let's just jump right into it. So this episode today, we're going to talk about culture, and this is chapter 4 in the book, where I kind of just go into what the culture of heaven is like, which you should be able to see the culture of heaven here on earth. Jesus started it, man. He was the first one. He gave us the example of what that was like, and then when he died and rose again, he empowered us with the Spirit of heaven, the Holy Spirit himself, so that we can take that and spread it all throughout the earth. So here's a great example. I was not originally born in the United States. I actually was born in Grenada. So I'm a citizen of Grenada, but I live in the United States. So dual citizenship is a thing. So when you get saved, you're born again. You are a citizen of the Kingdom of Heaven, and you are a citizen of whatever country you were born, your flesh was born in. So there are benefits that come with that. There are traditions, there are cultural things that we have. Growing up in a hood, you know, we love to give dap to our homeboys when we meet them, you know, and sometimes when it comes to Christians, they love to give hugs to other Christians that they meet, but just other people too. And then there are many traditions that different cultures carry on. In Grenada, around Christmas time, when it's the end of the year, you know what we do? We paint our houses. So I guess every year it's a new color? I don't know. But I remember that was one thing that we did continually. So every culture has an embodiment, a spirit about it, that you don't need to actually be in the country so that you can experience the country, right? If you ever came to my house, you would experience what it would be like to be in Grenada. You'd walk in the house, they would offer you food. And when they brought you food, it'd be a big plate of food that wide and that high. And that's just what it's like in Grenada. It's just very generous people, loving, and also people that will tell you as it is, but they don't do it because they hate you. They just try to let you know where you stand. But anyway, that's what it's like in Grenada. And we also have an accent. We talk a little different. We sound a little bit different. But with this is how you would know that you met somebody from Grenada. I'm sure all the other islands is something similar. So the culture of heaven, what is one thing that, you know, we can think of that would bring us close to the culture of what it would be like to be in heaven? A great example is giving. You know, giving in itself is not something that you strive to do or you have to do. You don't have to do it. But, you know, the norm in heaven is that you're a giver. You know, God loves a cheerful giver. You know, there's a scripture verse that talks about that. Actually, let's go into it. It's 2 Corinthians 9:6-8. So this is going to lead up to that. So it says, "But this I say, he who sows sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he who sows bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Every man according to his purpose in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or out of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. He is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you always having all sufficiency in all things may abound in every good work." Like, so you should be prospering and you should be moving forward in everything that you put your hand to, not just so that you can get a good old attaboy pat on your back, but so that you can help other people and you can be a blessing to them. You work at an establishment, that place should be getting more business. Customers should love coming to you because of your giving a smile, you're giving your positivity. You know, you're a giver. It's something that you naturally do. We give money, and guess what? You know, you can get back money. Matter of fact, people come and they shower you with things just because you're a giver. Don't mind my neighbor who's mowing his grass, or trying to. But the next thing, here's the next thing too. So if you don't want to give, that's because the revelation that you have about giving is just kind of not there yet. So I would suggest just finding scriptures that talk about giving, that talk about the benefits of it. And once you get that revelation and becomes alive to you in your mind, you start to understand that, hey, I already own it all. I'm a king's kid. My dad knows where everything is. And if he needs for me to get something so that I can move to another level in life, then, you know, I can get that. If I need a brand new TV because my TV broke and I don't have the money for it, guess what? There's a way for you to get the things that you need. You don't have to worry about it. So find a revelation on giving so you ain't got to stress out about it. My New York accent's coming out. I hear it. I'm sorry about that. The next thing is love. Love, culturally in the kingdom, is not a feeling. Love, you can say, is a commitment that you make to somebody that says, hey, I got your back. That says, you know, I see you as I see myself. I respect you, you know, and whether you respect me or not, you know, I still have I value you as a person, as an individual. You are valuable. And love in itself in the kingdom is that way. That's what makes you patient. That's what makes you kind. That's what makes you not want to envy and be boastful, like it says in 1 Corinthians 13:4-8. I want to give you another one. Of course, you know, everybody knows John 3:16, that God so loved the world that he gave his only son. And then, you know, God's heart in itself. So if God, they say, is love, and now his spirit lives in us, like that's the spirit, like exactly who God is. When you look at what Jesus did, that spirit resides within you. And that's part of the culture, the norm. Let's say it like that. The norm, normal attitude in heaven is like that. And we can have that attitude here too. The next thing is our words. In the kingdom of heaven, our words are things. God framed and created this world here with his words. And when you think about it, everything that we see, everything that we have, actually came from words, whether words that were written down in agreement and in a contract. You know, it didn't make magic, but we created, we drew blueprints, but it all came from words, because words are things and things are words. You know, so when you all think about it, that they're connected. So you speak what you want. You don't speak what you have. Proverbs 18:21 says, life and death is in the power of the tongue, and whoever loves it eats the fruit thereof. So you will have the fruit of whatever you speak. So your eyes will see what you speak. That's why most negative people, all they talk about all the time is what's wrong. And for them, in their world and in their understanding, this world is super jacked up. I mean, they're partially right. There is a lot of things that's jacked up, but there's still so much good in the world that you need to choose to see the positive. You need to speak positive. And guess what? You'll start to have more opportunity to notice the positive things that's going on. Those are some cultural norms of the kingdom. Here's another one for you. Mark 11:24. Therefore, I say unto you, what things therefore you desire when you pray, believe, be fully persuaded, have faith, know that you have received them and you shall have them. So, once again, when you pray, when you make a declaration to heaven, to God, of something that you need, right then and there, when you said that thing, you have to believe that that's when you've received it. And then one of the things you'll start to notice is that things will start to line up. You'll start to notice the different opportunities that's going to help you get where you're trying to get. So those are a couple of things that I talked about when it comes to culture. I hope this made sense to you guys. And I hope you're loving these little snippets for our devotional. And I hope that you come away feeling better, you feel fulfilled, and you're actually intrigued and want to go read the Bible a little bit more. So like I said, get the book, The Kingdom Mindset. Look it up on lulu.com. And I hope you're enjoying your day. Love you guys. Bye.